Okay.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Explore series hosted by Chitkara University. Today we have with us one of the best-selling English authors and the writer from the country, a celebrity in his own way, Chetan Bhagat. Welcome, Chetan, to the audience, to our region, to Chitkara University. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. Thank you for doing this and giving me a chance to interact with your students. Abhinit Jha is the first guy to say good evening, so I'll just say good evening to him. And you know, last time I came, I actually have come to Chitkara University. In fact, my family had come and we were very impressed by it, and it was many years ago. And I obviously, nothing beats like being there. And right. This is not bad, you know. At least you get a chance to give your ideas and talk to the students. During the lockdown, a lot of people, obviously, we watch TV and we see a lot of internet content, but we don't really figure out ki how to handle this, kya hoga, you know, like the what is our future. And I think even at this age, I've never seen something in my whole life. And to be a young person, you have all these dreams, you have all these assumptions that my life is going to be like this, and then the whole world literally stops. So I think it's good to get discuss that. And yeah. I thought that's why I thought it's a very good initiative on your side to do this.
Yeah, we thank you. We have fond memories of you coming, you know, to Chitkara before, and you know, for our audience, you know, Chetan, one of the best authors, storytellers, he's won the Filmfare Award for Best Screenplay in 2014 for Kai Poche. His last book, Girl in Room Number 105, 2018, and a lot of credits to his, decorated career. Now, the first question, Chetan, I would like to take up with you is that how have you kept your spirits high in your trying times, and also especially what has kept you busy with what kind of activities and hobbies in this lockdown especially?
Yeah, so it's a good question. I'm going to be very, very honest on what was my personal experience of this lockdown and also what has happened in the past. And obviously, what is it, where is it applicable to you? A lot of guys are wishing me, sorry guys, I don't mean to be rude, I'm just talking to Sir here, but especially Chitkara Royals, Alumni Network, Neera Chauhan, Rajni, Rajesh, Harshit, you know, and whoever else is coming, good evening in advance.
Yeah.
Okay, so, the first thing I would say is I have faced something sort of similar before, which others may not have. In 2003, in Hong Kong, there was a SARS virus, which was like Corona. It's actually a coronavirus only, or it's a little, you can say, cousin of the current COVID that we have. And I used to live in Hong Kong at that time. In fact, I was not famous. I was not even an author. I was working in a bank at that time, and Hong Kong was the worst hit place. The fatality rate was much higher than even Corona. It was 10-12%. But that disease did not spread worldwide as this one has, but it was still very scary for people living in Hong Kong. We literally had the same, everybody's wearing face masks and sanitizer and everything is getting cleaned all the time. There were no lockdowns. We couldn't have done lockdowns at that time. Technology, we were smartphones hadn't really come. Like, we had those Nokia phones. So there is no question of people being in touch like they are now, working from home. Was just not a possibility at that time. But so, short of that, everything else was done, and it was very scary. And people felt like it's the end of the world. People literally felt it's the end of the world over there. Hong Kong, which has a very big property market, like it's a very big real estate kind of city, property prices.
Yeah.
So, and 50% the property market fell. 50% the stock market fell, which is a very big number for already a very expensive kind of market. And it just literally fell in a month because people felt Hong Kong is finished. And you know, all the people started panicking and some said, what to do, right? And then it went away. And then the world came back. And the property market also came back. And the real estate market also came back. And in fact, went to new highs. It doubled after that. Since then, it has tripled maybe today. And, the life came back. And I remember people saying at that time, will we ever go back to concerts? Will we ever go back to... we did. In fact, people don't even remember it as much now because of coronavirus. We have to remember it. The first thing I want to tell you guys is, yes, there are some things that will change. And we will talk about that a little bit. But right. Those things were already changing. Like it's not like this webinar is something new. And I could see myself doing a couple of webinars for Chitkara, maybe next year too. Even if I have the ability to come, it just is one of the options, you know, like if it's not possible or something is to be, it's difficult to arrange or whatever. So even without Corona, some of these things will stay. But largely, humanity will come back. Good people will do well in life. Talented people will be in demand. People who work hard will be successful. None of those rules are changing. So I would like to tell all the students to not panic and not think that abhi ye ho gaya bas, abhi dukaan band hai, abhi band nahi hai, thode dino ke liye band hai. In fact, now already now the in India the lockdown is going to be considerably eased from next week, and then India can keep on doing it. Now I'm not saying that it was easy for me to adjust to this. You know, the second part of your question, how are you dealing with it? Even though I'd gone through SARS, even though it's just not easy for anyone to suddenly have so much change imposed on them and their life. I'll give you my example. In a writer's profession, you write alone in your room the whole year. It's literally like the main, it's like the profession of a writer is like an iceberg. You know how an iceberg 10% is up and 90% is below. The 10% up is what you see, book launches and, you know, newspaper and TV interviews and all that. My public visibility part is 10%. It's very fun. It's very enjoyable. But 90% of a writer's life is sitting alone in his room and write. Now, that is what I was doing whole of last year. I was sort of in a lockdown last year anyway. Okay. So now my book was finished. I was going to launch it in April. I was announcing. In May was the actual launch of the book, and nothing could stop us. I mean, it was all done. Amazon is my publisher and they can sell lots of books, and we had a promo, we had made a trailer, and we had a city-wise plan, we had partners. I can't tell you, everything was ready. The biggest launch ever, this, that, and then this hit, and then we had to stop everything. Now, I felt like this is not fair because I've done the 90% of the iceberg part. Now is the time for me to like go enjoy, release the book, get praise. Alone, I mean, it's worked, and now this is not right. I first few days, I just protested. And then the lockdown started and it just kept getting longer and longer. And I was like, okay, what do I do now? Now there is one thing I can do in the lockdown, which is sit and write again.
Right.
And that's the last thing I wanted to do. Because I'd been writing the whole year. I want to go out there. But I can't. I can't go. I can't sell. Amazon can't deliver. Nothing can happen. So I said, sit down and write. And that's what I've been doing now.
That's what you have.
Yeah. And the book. So the book that is to be released is ready. And it is absolutely ready to release. So whenever things get better, we'll release it. But until then, I'm writing the book after that, which may not even release this year. That may come next year. But I'm sitting and writing because I adapted to the situation. That is what I can do now. Now, coming to your students, maybe they had plans that I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. I'm going to do this and you couldn't do it. But you can do something. You can do something that when you go to bed at night, you honestly know, was your day productive or not? Okay. Right. So what I try to do, sir, is I just go to bed and I want the feeling in bed that I was sort of productive today. I'm not saying I'm going to be a big champion. It is difficult to do a lot in the lockdown. But I want to not waste my day. Do not waste days.
You self-motivated yourself and you were on to follow your passion, which you've been doing, and you You had a very strong balance of your mind, and that's what, you know, made you write the next book, which you plan to bring it next year. So would you like to add further, or I go to my next question? Do you have some more?
No, please go ahead. Yeah.
So, you know, this I'll read. We know that normally fiction follows life, but once in a while, life follows fiction. The Contagion movie, Contagion to Corona, is a classic case of life replicating fiction. What's your take on that?
You know, it is something, it's very, it's good if like what science fiction imagines is, like if they imagine a flying car, then if actually flying cars happen, that's actually a good thing. But sometimes if science fiction is imagining viruses and asteroids coming on Earth and they actually come, it is obviously, you know, all science fiction is rooted in some reality. They may not be very common, but it is a good science fiction is like, okay, it's possible. And I think people always kept talking about it. Yeah, it's possible. And, you know, this a disease is possible and a virus, you know, biological warfare, which we talk about sometimes, it's possible. But nobody thought or knew how to handle it when it actually comes. And it has come. And yeah, so, you know, sometimes life can be strange. I mean, if I had written a story last year saying that India will be shut down and nobody will be able to get out of the house and all factories will be closed, all schools will be closed, all restaurants will be closed, and nobody would have bought that story. People would have said, what is this nonsense? He's gone mad. It's not even possible in fiction. Even in fiction, I would not be allowed to imagine so bizarre a scenario. But here we are. Reality is stranger than fiction. Yeah,
that's how, you know, how uncertain and precarious, and we are passing through it. The next question is coming from a gentleman. He's Pranav Bhatt from the hospitality school from the university. And, how the final year students keep themselves motivated, who have been placed, the students who have been placed in a company, and they are not sure whether they'll be able to join or not. How do they keep themselves motivated?
Yeah, and you know, hotel management, man, I mean, that is, so if there are, everybody's been hit by this lockdown and corona, but the worst hit sectors, the worst hit sectors are airlines, hospitality, which is hotels and restaurants, travel, like agents, travel agents and things like that. These are some of the worst hit live events, you know. Like concerts and all kinds of those things. So they are really, really very badly hit. And I do express my sympathies. But it is not the end of the world. People love going out. That's why we live. We live to entertain ourselves and to travel and enjoy ourselves. Human beings cannot live like this, the way we are living now. It may take 6 months. It may be the last one to open. In fact, flights have a little bit opened also now. It and the vacation and hotels and all may be the last one to open. But it will open. And maybe 6 months sounds like a long time. But in the lifetime that you have, in the entire career that you have, it's not that bad. Now, I'm not, and you know better what you can learn in this time. Okay, yeah. But I'll just give an example. Okay,
yeah,
let us say you learn a little bit of Chinese, for example. Okay, I know China is not very popular these days, but fact is that Chinese people also travel. Chinese people are big travelers and they are getting richer. And so, of course, good English and good Indian languages matter for a hospitality person. But if you know a little bit of Chinese, it may help you one day in your career. And you may never get a chance to learn it like you can now, right? Ab ye sochne ka ek nazariya hai. You can say this is the worst time. I can't get a job. I was supposed to be working. Or you can say I have a pause and I can learn something jo mujhe kabhi mauka nahi milega. And that is what, you know, like so many people have met me in my life because I'm a writer and they say, I want to write a book. So I say, okay, likho fir pen paper lo or ya computer lo or baith ke likhna shuru karo. Kuch bhi likho, gandhi book likho. लेकिन लिखो एंड देन दिस इज सर टाइम नहीं है नाउ आई एम ट्राइंग टू फाइंड दोस पीपल सिंह आपने कहा था कि आपके पास बुक लिखने का टाइम नहीं, आप लिखो बैठ के.
That's a good one. In fact,
I read somewhere it was that if you are not doing it, what you said you will do right now, you never lack time. You lack the discipline.
Right. It's the discipline and the habit. Yeah. Very important. Yeah. I think that's a good takeaway for the students, you know, to have some discipline around it and a routine, which is, I think, because see, Please say.
This discipline thing, I know you have some amazing questions and people are also asking important questions, but this, because I want to make sure that I give this to students something, you know, when I come for a session like this, I can just talk idhar udhar ki baatein, but I want to tell you about something about discipline. What is this discipline? It's not like fauji utke, like, you know, parade karo. One is that discipline, but what does it mean for normal, like non-army people, and what does it mean for you? It is still important. It is something, you know, discipline is something, doing something when you don't feel like doing it.
Mm.
I'm putting it in a simple way. Doing something when you don't feel like doing it. Let's say you have to go to the gym. You feel like going to the gym and you go. Great. You feel like studying today. You study. Great. But what about the days you don't feel like studying?
Mm.
What about the day you don't want to go to the gym? What about the day, you know, you don't want to eat healthy and still can you do it? Mm. That is discipline. And that is across the branches you guys are all studying, engineering to hotels, to whatever you're studying. That is such a big quality. Tell me something, me sitting down again in the lockdown and writing a new book, what has that got to do with writing? It has got to do with discipline. I sat down and I said, I'm going to do it. That is, I think, what has helped me, whether I had to clear an entrance exam in my life or to write a book or whatever, is the discipline which a lot of people lack. A lot of people know their physics and maths and the engineering. A lot of people know how to do a hotel principles or front office. But do they have the discipline? Which is, in a very simple way, can you do something when you don't feel like doing it? Because you know it's good for you.
Right.
You know it's good for you, but you don't feel like doing it. So abhi kya karoge? Netflix dekhoge ya baith ke kuch pad sakte ho? Lekin Netflix dekhne ka jyada man hai, padhne ka man nahi hai. Now the guy who studies is the guy who has the discipline. So you have to practice discipline in the lockdown. What the lockdown does is, sir chale gaye abhi. Right. Okay. You might be doing online classes and all that, but it's not the same as college. It's not the same as your office, your boss shouting at you, 8 baje meeting hai, kyun nahi aaya ye wo. You can chill.
Got it.
So you are the teacher, you are the parent, you are the boss in your own head, and you can create that self-discipline, or you can just say, mujhse nahi hoga yaar. And I think that will separate people after the lockdown. Those who have learned discipline will come out stronger, and those who have not learned discipline will come out weak.
Perfect. I think you very well elaborated the meaning of discipline and how they should go about it. And I'm sure that this answer could be a turning point with the students, some of them. Better would be for all of them. So the next question coming up is that once you've mentioned, I think, that not only scoring higher marks is important, it's very important to also market yourself. Could you just, share it again, what exactly it means for a student to express, open up, and though for those who are actually personality shy, and how do they do about it? Though they are brilliant, but they're shy, they're born like that. So how do they do it? How important?
You know, I was a shy student, believe it or not. I was a shy student. In fact, a lot of my books, the characters are main characters, always that shy student. I remember I couldn't even talk. I couldn't even give a full answer in front of teachers. And it's okay to be shy. I mean, you don't have to be like yaro ka yaar, and you don't have to be like hundreds of people want to talk to you and things like that. But marketing has become extraordinarily important in today's world. See, everybody has content everywhere. Everybody is distracted because of their phone. You know, sab ke paas time pass karne ki kami nahi hai abhi. Ek time tha, log bore hote the, poochte the, kaise ho, ye kya kar raha hai, wo kya kar raha hai. Now nobody cares about you.
Mm.
You have to tell people, care about me.
Mm.
You have to tell people I'm important. I'm being very honest. Yeah. When I started writing, I remember people told me ki, यार चेतन ये राइटिंग वाला पंगा मत लो, ये कोई पूछता नहीं है राइटर्स को हमारे देश में, और कोई नहीं जानता, एंड ओनली फिल्म स्टार्स एंड क्रिकेटर्स दीज बिकम द सेलिब्रिटी. आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ माय टाइम व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड 15-20 इयर्स अगो, एंड दे सेड बिकॉज़ इट्स जस्ट वेरी डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज़ पीपल डोंट बाय बुक्स दैट इजीली. आई सेड हाउ अबाउट द मार्केटिंग देम, एंड दे सेड दैट कौन करेगा, पब्लिशर कितनी करे, पब्लिशर तो 100 बुक्स छाप रहा है साल के, तो एक बुक के कितने कितनी मेहनत कर लेगा वो, तो अल्टीमेटली तो सबसे ज्यादा बुक की सक्सेस उसकी तो एक मतलब यू नो ही विल पुट सम एफर्ट बट ही विल प्ले द डाइवर्सिफाइड बेट कि 100 हैं, 5 चल जाएंगे ठीक है, दैट्स हाउ द इंडस्ट्री वर्क्स. बट इट्स योर बुक, फॉर यू इट्स योर एंटायर करियर इज दैट वन बुक एज अ राइटर. सो आई सेड मैं खुद करूंगा. सो आई वॉज नॉट नोन एट दैट टाइम बट आई डिसाइडेड दैट apart from the writing skill I need a marketing skill which is completely different and has nothing to do with writing. The hotel management guy needs it, engineer needs it, the writer needs it, Chitkara University needs it. I mean nobody is going to, even no matter how great you are, agar aap sona hai aur wo mitti mein hai to usko khodna ke bahar nikal ke chamakna padega sone ko ki main sona hu dekho mujhe. So wo, that's the world we are living in. It doesn't mean you're constantly selling yourself.
Got it. Yeah.
It is, you know, my first book when it came out, I still remember it was in Vasant Kunj. I was doing a book launch in Cafe Coffee Day. It's a small cafe, like literally kitne 20-25 wahan pe seats honge total. And I remember I was launching my book there and 20-25 mein 10-15 log baithe hue the. And I literally went up to the people and said, I am launching my book there. Can you please turn your chair 50% in this direction? Not full. 50% इधर कर लो ताकि आप सुन लो, आपको अगर मेरी बातें अच्छी लगती हैं तो मे बी यू कैन कंसिडर बाइंग माई बुक. आई रिमेंबर दैट टाइम इट वॉज 95 rupees. आई सेड इट्स वेरी चीप, इट्स एज एक्सपेंसिव एज अ कॉफी. नाउ आई वॉज नॉट थिंकिंग बट दैट वॉज माई मार्केटिंग पिच कि इट्स एज एक्सपेंसिव एज अ कॉफी, अगर आपको मेरी बातें अच्छी लगती हैं तो ले लेना. एंड आई रिमेंबर आई सोल्ड 5 books.
Yeah.
5 books. बट यू नो आई डिड इट. टुडे आई डोंट नीड टू डू इट बिकॉज़ आई हैव सोशल मीडिया एंड पीपल नो माई नेम एंड ऑल दैट. बट आई एम सेइंग दैट स्पिरिट वॉज देयर. सो यू, there is no shame in marketing good work,
right?
No, you don't have to be very chatty, but you need to, if you have something to offer that will benefit other people, there is, why should there be shyness in that? If my book makes you laugh, if my books make you happy, if my talk inspires you, why should I not sell it?
Right.
Because I know it is benefiting you.
Right.
Not, you know, if your university is helping students succeed in life, why should you not sell it? तो ये शर्मीलापन जो है ये तो इतना नहीं होना चाहिए. हम तो वैसे ही पंजाबी हैं सर, तो we are little more बेशरम than the rest of India. But it's not about, but you know, marketing is a very important skill. India की कल्चर में उसको अटेंशन देते नहीं है, एंड इसको people don't see it as a science in itself, but it is. And your individual brand is
science in itself, and students should imbibe, explore it more. Yes. Themselves and you know, express and share good work what they're doing, right? Great. So yeah. Chetan, I have another question which is coming up from Dr. Niyati Chitkara, and then I'll go to another question from Dr. Madhu, our vice chancellor, and then we go to some audience question. Dr. Niyati is asking, what is going to be the future of education post COVID? Any thoughts around it?
Yeah, so I'll give you all sides because I have teenage boys at home who are doing online school now. I can give their point of view also. See, some of the secular trends were happening. Like, it's not like there were no web-based education companies like Baiju, or like there were online courses already happening, UpGrad. There's so many other companies. And in fact, colleges themselves were doing some online education. So there was 10-20% growth happening every year in this anyway. What has happened now is a 5-year push. This COVID has given a 5-year push because people have been forced to choose that method, which was slowly getting acceptance. Now people are saying, okay, and it's happening to shopping also. See, a lot of people, like many years ago, people said, how can you buy a pair of pants online? But now a lot of people buy it. And now still, now let's say youngsters are buying it. Now their parents are also buying it. You know, they're also okay buying clothes on. So 5 years of acceleration in that trend has happened right now. So that definitely is going to be there. So if I was part of running Chitkara, I would definitely have an online strategy. I would definitely, it doesn't mean you have to become a Baiju or anything, but and every way is different. There's no one line answer to this, but to not, and especially when 5G comes, you know, 5G is going to come in a year or so. It's going to basically mean very fast Wi-Fi in a phone everywhere you go. So obviously more resolution, better, easier to get the web chats. I think this app that we are using is good, or Zoom is also good, but it'll only improve. You know,
right.
You may have I was discussing with some people, we could have an app one day which kind of makes a 3D hologram of you and me, and we are sitting in a room.
Right.
It's possible. I mean, it's not that difficult if you have a little more bandwidth. So, so you must have that online strategy. Now, having said that, students hate not going to college, not going to school. First time in my life, I've seen students saying, school kab khulega. Hamesha bachche bolte, school kab band hoga. So, because learning is not just professor teaching you. Learning is, you know, the friendships you make, the group work you do, the partners you have, the arguments you have with your teacher, and you're saying this is right, no, this is right, the lab work you do, the festivals you organize, the debates you do. I can't even tell you how much happens in, even Chitkara is always doing something. Now, that may not always have a grade, or that may not always come in an exam, but trust me, that's education.
Mm-hmm.
That's education. You can't replace it. You can't just log into a this Zoom or Facebook call every morning for 5 hours and become an amazing person who will go out there well educated. And no, you need to have people interaction. So I think that will also be there. That unfortunately is not happening right now because of COVID, but the demand is very high for that. So I think a hybrid kind of thing will be there. Some of the non-essential things will quickly move to online. And one things that when people will make coming to college count more. Like we are all together. Why are we together? Not just to, do something which we can just do it over video. But, you know, let's get together and do something. I think that will change. But
right.
So I think that's some of my thoughts on this.
No, I think there are key takeaways around it. It's going to be a hybrid situation, I think. Online endeavors are going to be on, plus, you know, the college environment and the social life and community life of students. The next question coming up is from Dr. Madhu Chitkara, our Pro Chancellor. You are a youth icon, Mr. Chetan, in India. And in your views, what direction has changed amongst the youth today, like comparing the today's crisis, do you think there is a change in their direction? And if it has changed, you know, what it is in your thoughts?
Yeah. Ma'am, I was youth icon when I came to your college. Since then, I have grown older. So I don't know if I'm youth icon, I can say, but I do still work with the youth. And
yeah, but you know, most of your books are on colleges and student life.
Yeah, yeah. And I still kind of keep in touch with them and through their comments, and I can figure out. I think we are not realizing the economic crisis in front of us. I'm always an optimistic kind of person, but having worked in banks before and from investment banking and working in regional markets around Asia, countries did a lot for their economy all over the world to make sure there is growth and there are enough jobs. And I think India is still not, now of course there is COVID, so sab kai bura hal hai. But even before COVID, we were not doing enough to generate growth. And the students were not focusing too much on the economy and pushing the governments to open the economy more, get more business. You know how in the 90s, there was a whole opening up of the economy. And I think we are the 19th generation. We kind of benefited from that. But I think now we are moving towards more and more closed kind of economy. And it's going to get difficult for people to get jobs. And only the best people, or only people who are very good, or people who are good at marketing themselves will do it. And what has also happened is that data has become too cheap.
Mm.
I'm being totally honest. a couple of hundred rupees, you can have, I don't know, unlimited GB and watch TikTok and Instagram and सबके दर्शन करोगे थोड़ी थोड़ी देर टिकटॉक के, थोड़ी देर इंस्टाग्राम के, थोड़ी देर यूट्यूब. तो लगता है अरे ज्यादा नहीं, मैं इंस्टाग्राम में तो 20-25 मिनट करता हूँ बस, ज्यादा नहीं करता. पर आप 25 मिनट वो करते हो, फिर आप 25 मिनट टिकटॉक करते हो, फिर आप 25 मिनट फेसबुक करते हो, फिर आप यूट्यूब करते हो, फिर उसके बाद आप स्नैपचैट करते हो, ये तो सोशल मीडिया हुआ. फिर उसके बाद आप कोई और ऐप करते हो, फिर आप व्हाट्सएप पे लोगों को जवाब देते हो, फिर उसके बाद यू नो फोन कर. सो इट्स अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम दैट गोज इन दिस थिंग. And you know, if you dare all the students, check your phone ka screen time. I check mera apna 4-5 ghante per day, you know. So it's a lot. And if people are not going to focus on the important things and keep on just giving time pass on social media, you are wasting a lot of your life. Like in if you're 70 years old, you're retired, theek hai, baith ke karte raho. My mother does Facebook, it's great for her. Sits around, usne meri photo nahi like ki, main bhi nahi karungi, ye wo karte rehte hain sara din. That's okay. But for a youngster to do it too much is, you are not going to get the time back. You are now at Chitkara.
Yeah,
you can still say, I don't know. Yeah, you are at Chitkara now. You are at university, college now. Mujhe nahi aata hai, main seekhta hoon. But 5-10 years later, you can't say, यार तब तो इंस्टाग्राम देख रहा था.
You lost the time, you know. And what exactly, concluding on your answer, what is the ideal time you suggest the screen time for a student at the peak of his education career?
Yeah, so zero बोलूंगा तो फिर लोग जूते मारेंगे and कभी नहीं आएंगे मेरे वेबिनार में. And zero होने नहीं वाला, and zero जरूरी भी नहीं है. I think two hours. 2 hours of time pass time, and the you know like this, or is a educational webinar, or if it's a class you're doing, and if you're doing something on product, you know it. I can't judge ki ye theek hai wo theek nahi hai, mera kaam nahi hai wo karna. You be your own judge ki was I wasting my time or was I learning something. I mean, I type on the computer, so technically when I write it's screen time, but that is good screen time because I'm working and I'm creating something. But if I'm watching, I don't know, puppy videos on YouTube, which I sometimes do, it's, or like babies laughing. I mean, it's a very good to uplift your mood. You see babies laughing, but it's stupid. It's really a waste of time. And it's waste of time for me at 46. And for if you're 17, 18, 20, it is very crucial. I can still have my book 6 months late. Nobody will say anything to me. But for you, that exam or that interview or that job is not going to wait,
Right. I think that makes, a great sense for the young children at the peak of their career, your advice. I'll just move on to the next question. Like, this is something like, despite so much name and fame, Chetan, you have achieved so much and you have a commercial success also, which everybody dreams of reaching that stage. What is still that you dream and yearn in life?
Yeah, it's a good question. I'm just figuring out myself more, and I think I've figured out myself much more now. And I think the lockdown has really helped also, because you are not always running around here there. Otherwise, I remember I took 100 flights last year. You were taking 100 flights last year, and now I'm seeing how scary it is to go in flights with all those masks and all that. So I don't know if I will take 100 again. And now I haven't taken any for the last 3 months almost. So it has given me time to reflect. And I think, I have, from a financial or fame point of view, I've achieved a lot. I think I want to have a balance in life. Some people are more ambitious. They want to keep on growing, and I can if I want. But I want to be happy, and I want to don't want to just keep running around too much. I want to do selective work. I like writing stories. That makes me happy. Whether I write a story for a book or for a Netflix or something, one story a year, one in 2 years is good enough for me. I'll slow down the pace of my travel and just help others. I'm genuinely trying to help youngsters, telling things that I wish someone had told me in college, because I am very scared. We didn't have this stupid content on the phone when we were studying. Our option was dhoop mein jaake cricket khelo ya IIT ki padhai karo. So ab fir bhi hum dhoop mein jaake cricket khelna pasand karte the, lekin itna nahi khel sakte. पसीने भी आ गए। हाँ मतलब कि लोग चाहिए और सब बिजी है, अब तो पॉकेट से फोन निकालो और एक घंटा कहाँ गया पता ही नहीं लगा, इतने में तो मैं फिजिक्स का एक चैप्टर पढ़ लेता। So that, I mean, if I had that, this phone that I have in my pocket, I don't think I could have made it. So I feel very concerned and I want to help. So yeah, I want to now use the...
You want to help youngsters, help them shape up?
Yeah. Yeah, because they come to me and they ask me, you know, they of course read my books, but they say, you've gone to those colleges, you know, what can you tell us? So I said, okay, theek hai, karte hain. Apne liye aur kitna karunga, abhi kar liya bahut, you know, like, there's no end.
So you yearn to be happy, you want to help the youngster, you know, and that's what a good answer is. Yeah. And great goal, and keep writing also. So the next question I have is that coming on to, you know, sorry, I'm looking at my questions also. Social media impact, you know, a lot of celebrities. How does it affect the celebrities when the fan following goes up and down? So how do they have a very balanced mental makeup, and how do they handle it? How is it for them, for celebrities and people who've got massive?
Yeah,
you know,
it's a little crazy. In the beginning, it can get very crazy, and I think it depends how much you let it affect you. And I know people who literally their life runs on it. Like, not only are they posting, they're posting everything all the time. Like, you know, what I ate for lunch and breakfast and you know, the baby in my house cried and yeah, wo sab lagate rehte wo, and it's their whole life is almost like a reality show, and they like it, and they like to get the growth that obviously the more you post, the more people will follow you and all that. So I don't like that. So I personally realize there's something wrong if you're doing that, because that is, I don't know, that's it. There is just a certain space you need to keep as your own to be happy in life. Because if you allow people to comment on everything you're doing, it's a recipe for trouble. Because one day they will not like what you're doing, and then you know, then you will feel very insecure and all that. So I think over time you get used to it. There was a time I used to track my followers and all that. I don't now. I will maybe see it once a month. That is just to get an idea of what's going on. But I don't really track. There is enough. Those who want to listen to me, they can. And those who don't want to listen to me, no, that's okay. Because human beings weren't designed to have millions of people reacting to you all the time. That's not what our brains are not designed for that. So even if you're a celebrity, you still have the same human, one brain and, you know, one body. And it's going to be difficult if you have so much feedback. It's too much feedback, you know. Right. So you have to find the balance that it's find not, you're not, yeah, but some people can't. And I know some people are really, they are always like, I need them and their phone is on, because to put so much content, they have to shoot it all the time. They're shooting. So I'm like, tum mere se baat kar rahe ho ya mere ko telecast kar rahe ho? Like that.
Great. You know, since we are coming to the last quarter of our conversation, I have two questions, Chetan, and then I'll go for some quick questions, you know, with answers. This question is coming from Mr. Anshul, and we also had a similar question from others. What are your comments on the country, India, handling the pandemic and the migrant issue? You know, truth, facts versus fiction. If you can just share your thoughts, how we could make it better, and how you know, how your thoughts have been. What has been going in your minds watching all this?
On what is going on, like when I see the
how well we have done handling the whole pandemic.
I mean, we've done as well as we could, frankly. You know, we have done as well as we could, but that doesn't mean it's good enough. And I think the real problem is what was happening before the pandemic. For the last 10, 20 years, I have been constantly been somebody who says that we should, and I don't want to discuss politics at this platform, but the focus should be on the economy and making India a very rich country and a big, affluent and strong country. We are not strong. We have only, we love our country and I love it a lot too. And there's a lot of strength in our resolve, but fundamentally we don't have so much money. We don't have, like in the Europe, people who have lost their jobs, 80% of salaries they are getting every month because the government is paying it. You know, we don't have that luxury. We were fighting for weeks on who will pay for the migrant labor's second class train ticket home. So it's because we actually are not able to afford. Our country is not rich. Government is therefore not rich. The reserves are not that much. So it is, given all that, we are not doing so badly. Yes, 1.5 lakh cases sounds like a lot, and it's probably going to go to 3 lakh, and it's probably going to go to maybe 5 to 10 lakhs also. But India has 1.4 billion people. Like the US has 1/4 the population, and they already have close to 20 lakh cases. So if we have 10 lakh and our population is 4 times that much and we have half the cases, it's still not that bad. It's still horrible that Corona came, but I'm just saying. And right now, it looks like we are at 1.5 lakh. You know, maybe we'll stay under 10. So it's not bad. It's a good effort. But I think we need to decide what kind of country we want to be in 5 to 10 years. If there is another one of these, are we again going to be suffering so much? Like when you see migrant labor suffer so much, when you see people in slums suffer so much, it should not be like this. But at the end of the day, what to do? You know, people are poor. So we just are seeing it now. So I think that way we just need to be a stronger country to fight these pandemics.
Fair enough. There are a lot of opportunities, and more we come together, we can do a better impact and make everybody's lives much better. This question is related to your previous answer on the screen time. So Komal Sethi is asking that how to convince our youth to cut short the screen time.
मतलब देखो इसमें मेरे को कन्विंस अगर आपको कन्विंस होना है तो गड़बड़ है बिकॉज अच्छा जब आप सिगरेट पीते हो तो कहते हैं ना सिगरेट पीने से 5 मिनट लाइफ कम हो जाती है सो हाउ डू दे नो 5 मिनट कम होती है मुझे पता नहीं कैसे नापते हैं वो बट दे से नाउ यू हैव 24 आवर्स इन अ डे एंड यू नो गेटिंग रेडी एंड स्लीपिंग एंड ऑल दैट मैक्स यू हैव 15 प्रॉपर वेकिंग आवर्स मैक्सिमम उससे भी कम ही होते हैं नाउ उसमें अगर आपने 5 घंटे या 6 घंटे स्क्रीन टाइम में लगा दिए I know some people who are 8 to 10 hours also, you know who you are. Now you wasted 30-40% of your life in that. It's the same as cigarettes because your life became shorter 1/3. Your productive life became less. So you want, it's like the same as the drug addiction. Drugs lower your life, cigarettes lower your life, and faltu screen time lowers your life. And only thing is it's completely legal and you can keep it in your pocket all the time and next to your bed when you are sleeping so that you don't have good sleep also now because raat ko agar halki si bhi neend khuli to yaar check maar hi lo kya pata duniya mein meri zarurat pad jaye kisi ko you know kuch nahi hoga so jao ek hafta dekho puri duniya ruk gayi 3 mahine kuch nahi hua na you know everybody is still in their place so you are nothing is that important that you can't keep that thing away You will not get this time back. You cannot say in an interview, sir, us time bahut achha YouTube pe video chal rahe the, pad nahi paya main. You can't say that. So you decide. Nobody's going to stop you. It's going to be in your pocket. It's very easy to see it. But you got to. I hope that's convincing. I don't know.
Absolutely. I think that's very logical. And wonderful answer you have given. Now I'll go to a question and then go to the quicker questions for you. What do you think India of 2022 is going to be, in your opinion, especially for authors and filmmakers? I think the film industry, which you are very closely associated, has also been affected. What do you think India of 2022 is going to be?
I think 2022 tak things will be back. I'm hoping people will. The economy will bounce back quite hard and fast. I do believe that. And that much optimism I have. Theaters will be open by then. Movies will be coming. I think this, again, like I said, like online education has gone up a lot. Online entertainment will, it was already coming, right? Netflix and Amazon Prime were growing. But they've grown a lot in the last few months. Like in the last 3 months, Netflix added 1.6 crore new subscribers worldwide. And there are 50 lakh corona cases. So more than the corona cases, they've had the accounts. So unka to theek chal raha. Unki dukaan theek chal raha. So that will be there much bigger. So I think some of those things. I will probably be trying to do something for Netflix by 22, hopefully.
This is a question coming from Mr. Ravi Chetan. What are your thoughts on Indian writers as compared to foreign authors?
Well, I mean, there is no, there are good writers in India and there are good writers abroad and there are very bad writers abroad and they're very bad writers in India. So okay. I don't think it's a nationality thing. What is happening is now Indian writers are pehle in 20, 30 years ago, Indian writers used to copy Western writers abroad. They would write stories what the Western people want to hear. It's like Indian films, you know, the, that are made for festivals abroad and those nobody watches in India.
Hmm.
So now there's a lot more confidence in writers and they are writing Indian stories. Like even I just saw this series called Patal Lok. It's very good. Please watch it on Amazon Prime. And it's very real and very Indian and, you know, like very dark, by the way. It's disturbingly violent. So that I'm not sure if all of you can watch. But what I'm saying is the writers have just made a very Indian story. And that was not happening earlier.
Good. That's a good recommendation. This is next question, Jaitan, coming is from an entrepreneur who runs a startup, Sharad. He's asking, how do you feel technology might enhance the experience of reading? Do you feel a VR, virtual reality experience might add or help in experiencing the content of the book through visuals?
Wow, it's an interesting thought. Why not? Why not? If VR gets popular, if VR gets popular, and I think a lot of companies are trying to make VR popular, and then yes, you could have a reading experience on that. The thing about reading though is it's the simplest form of storytelling in a way. It's just words and you can literally now tell stories in 3D graphics, but you can still tell a story in words and still people read it. To me, tech will help distribution of books. To me, tech will help in e-reading, of course, Kindle and stuff like that. But distribution, you know, when I wrote my first few books, there were no bookshops in like a Bhilai or a Bikaner. There are no bookshops. By fiction, there are textbook shops. But now with online, like Amazon reaches anywhere. So that kind of benefits are there. Even though technology is also harmful, my competitor is not other books. It is TikTok, you know, what to do. Nonsensical okay. stuff. People keep watching on TikTok. What to do? But it's my competition.
Yeah. So, Chetan, this question is from me. Like, you were in a job, you know, and we live with a lot of insecurities while we are building our career. You were in a job. You spent a decade in overseas. You were with the bank. You also wanted to be a chef. But while in job, you know, wrote books and you became one of the best-selling or top-selling authors of the country. And then you totally switched on to writing. So do you think that you were very, you know, balanced enough to take a calculated risk and that's what you advise to other students or what should they go by their gut or what?
There was some element of calculated risk that I'd saved money, I'd investment money. I can almost do a separate webinar on how to save and invest because I was working in a bank. So I said the first thing about the banking I need to learn is my own personal banking and my personal savings. But having said that, it was a risk. I mean, it's a big risk to leave a job and, you know, which you are already established in, you've got some seniority in, and it makes a lot of money. Investment banking, my gosh, I mean, I'm not bragging, but it pays very well. And it is very hard to leave that at whatever 33, 34 is when I thought I'll retire from banking and do books. It was like many people, including my publisher. Said, don't do it, sir. Please, mat karo. Main nahi guarantee le raha aapki. Kal ko logon ka taste badal jayega, flavor change ho jayega. Fir kya karenge aap? And this was like more than 10, 15 years ago. So it is a valid point, but you know, there was some calculation. Yeah, I wouldn't go hungry. Tuition padha lenge, that kind of. But there was a leap of faith. There is a jump. Even if you know, you make a little net below the circus guy when he has to jump.
Yeah,
it's still scary, you know.
Yeah, it takes a lot, but you know, you have to do it. You can't hang in between. and you did it. There's a quick question which are coming up. What do you think are the quick skills which you recommend? This is from Asha Majmer. One quick skills one can obtain while writing a blog.
But guys, you know, the best way is to write and send it to people. And firstly, keep it simple. Have a point to it. So first is keep your language simple. Second is have a point to it. What is that blog entry about? What are you? What is the new thing somebody will learn from it? Or is it funny? Or is it interesting to look at new things? Kuch uska purpose kya hai? It doesn't have to be a very deep purpose, but what is it? You are reporting something. You are giving your opinion on something. You are making people laugh. What are you doing? And third is get people to give you very, very brutally honest feedback. I still do it for my books. And I have a set of people, even though they know that my books sell a lot, they're honest enough that they will say, I got bored in this part. I didn't like this. This was good. So you must, and blogging, the best thing is you send it to people on WhatsApp now, and all your, dal to pale to sare WhatsApp groups mein, aur bolo, I am trying to be a blogger. Can you please read this and give me your genuine suggestions? That is also what we spoke about earlier, marketing. And that is marketing plus feedback. अब इसको शर्मीला बोलो, शर्मीले हो तो व्हाट्सएप में तो फॉरवर्ड भी आ सकता है ना, उसमें कोई डांस करने को तो नहीं कह रहे लोगों के आगे. सो यू नो, सो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग यू हैव टू गेट फीडबैक एंड गेट बेटर एंड देन यू विल नो, दे विल टेल यू, पीपल टेल यू वंस दे नो दैट दे विल टेल यू, यार ये तो क्या कहना चाह रहा है, मजा नहीं आया, दोबारा कर. बट देन इंप्रूव एंड चेंज एंड सेंड अनदर वन एंड अनदर वन, दैट्स लाइफ. You get better. Don't quit if they say I didn't like it.
Right. Keep moving on.
Yeah.
Bilkul sahi. And you've got a great sense of humor. You know. Next question is that who are your favorite authors? You know, and one book you think you could have written and but you did not. Somebody else wrote it.
I would have really liked to write the book Animal Farm. Everybody studies that book in school. 1984 also, but Animal Farm. George Orwell, I would say, is my favorite author from so many. And I mean, that's just one of them that comes to mind. R.K. Narayan was very good also. Yeah.
The next question coming up is which best-selling novel of yours you think changed your destiny and brought fortune?
Well, I think everybody agrees it's a 5-point summer, my first one, and that became Three Beards, and that just it changed my life. It literally just, I never thought, I just thought it's a hobby, and it just, like, I didn't even buy the lottery ticket and it became the lottery ticket, but I did the work, I did write it. So you have to sometimes just keep on trying different things. Every time you try something in life, that's a lottery ticket you buy. Kai baar lag jati hai.
So you've written books in English largely, and Hindi mein aap likhte hain ya likhne ka sochenge aage?
Hindi mein main column likhta hun jo mera dainik bhaskar mein aata hai. Hindi mein main script likhta hun jo script mein kya hota hai ki aapke ek to kafi logon ke sath aap milke likhte ho aur usme grammar aur uska Hindi language ko aap thoda bahut teda meda bhi kar sakte ho, chalega matlab do char English. But when you write a Hindi book, it has to hold a certain standard of language. Jo meri, I mean, nahi hai. Mine is Hindi mixed with Punjabi, so and Delhi, and you know, like, so I don't think I can write a full book in Hindi. I can write an article, I could write a script, but I can talk, I can give a Hindi mein talk, but yeah, writing a book is difficult.
So does the choice of audience affect your style of writing?
Not too much, but you know, when I'm writing an editorial in a paper, obviously I'm not going to, you know, I have to use a little formal language in Times of India and write a little, be a little more polite. And when I'm writing for youngsters, I know I can be very casual. In fact, I should, you know, be totally politically incorrect. Jo ban mein, jo dil mein hai, wo bolo, because that works better. So, to that extent, utna, but not too much. I mean, obviously the platform is important, you know. So yeah.
There is a very interesting question coming from Arunachal Pradesh, Talin Margin. Sir, my question to you is how to improve reading and writing without internet connectivity?
Wow. Firstly, you do have internet connectivity right now because you're on this talk. So firstly, very, very nice. Bahut achcha laga, Talin, all the way from Arunachal Pradesh, you've come for this. you know, you can get books. You internet connectivity may not be always, but you can for one time go to a bookshop and get a lot of books. I mean, book reading is the best thing without internet. A book, you don't have to charge a book at night. Yeah. And you can share it and light bhi chale jaye to internet kya light ke bina bhi din mein to padh sakte ho, mombatti mein bhi padh sakte ho. And you can of course, even if you have an e-reader, you can download them once you have it, and then you know, okay, like you can with very limited connectivity also function. So I think reading has that as a very big benefit. Thanks, Talin is saying. So yeah.
Thank you, Chetan, for answering that question. Coming on to the last two, what are the components, Chetan, according to you, for especially for the youth and the students, components of inner peace and happiness? And this is something happiness you were yearning,
See, inner peace and happiness के लिए काफी गुरुजी घूम रहे हैं, जैसे आपको बताएंगे. But you know, I'm very practical kind of guy. And you need to, and maybe this is God, some spirituality in part of it, that you need to know yourself and who you are. You cannot be who you are not if you want to be happy. If you are always, you can, we all like, thoda bahut, we all adjust. Yeah, chalo yaar. दुनिया के लिए, फैमिली के लिए, बट लार्जली यू हैव टू बी हु यू आर, एंड इफ यू नॉट देन यू कांट बी वेरी हैप्पी, एंड यू हैव टू वर्क एंड डू प्रोडक्टिव थिंग्स इन लाइफ. आई नो इट साउंड्स लाइक, लोग कहते क्या बात कर रहे हो, ऐश करनी चाहिए, उससे खुशी मिलती है, पर नहीं मिलती है, काम करने से खुशी मिलती है. दैट्स माय व्यू.
परफेक्ट, परफेक्ट.
अच्छा काम करने से खुशी मिलती है.
हाँ बिल्कुल, और जो भी शेयर करो किसी के अच्छे के लिए, जो आपने पहले भी बोला. चेतन, वुड यू लाइक टू शेयर कि आपकी अगली बुक्स के कुछ नाम? उससे पहले मैं ये पूछूं कि टाइटल्स कहाँ से ढूंढते हो आप?
Titles are always, see, again, it's part of marketing. Title is very frankly what draws the reader. Of course, today my name also is there, but the title, you know, the title like a half girlfriend, ring, like suddenly, ये क्या हो गया, या two states क्या है? So three idiots का जो concept. So the idea is to create curiosity, you know, with every title. My new book is ready. Literally, I wish I could tell you more, but now I will tell you when the lockdown is over, and then we launch it. So then we'll do. Maybe I'll come to Chitkara and do a launch also. I don't know.
You have come to Chitkara. When shall we expect you? After 2-3 months, once this settles, would you like to come first and launch it with us at Chitkara?
Yeah, why not? Civil Aviation Ministers, आपको बोलो जरा खोले और थोड़ी फ्लाइट नाइट है. कर रहे हैं सर. Yeah, of course. You know, the joy is to go out there and meet readers. So why not? I'll keep that. Tell my team that.
Right, and we'll keep a track on how things shape up, and be the first ones to invite you to the campus. And you know, coming on to my concluding, you know, question is that the question is how have your children, your lovely two boys, you know, and your family benefited from your larger presence at home?
Oh, I don't know. They may be wondering, kab jayenge papa waise? But I think I never had the time as I have had in the last 2-3 months to be there. I think I've really gotten to know, my boys are 15, twins. I've gotten to know their nature and their strengths and weaknesses. And now they're getting into grade 11, and it's important, like a good, like a senior classes in school. And I'm getting a chance to understand them and shape up their habits. जो चीजें मैं यहाँ बोलता हूँ वही अब मैं बच्चों को बोलता हूँ. टू बी डिसिप्लिन्ड, टू मेक ईच डे काउंट, टू फिगर आउट हु यू आर. सो आई एम लाइक देयर फ्री का पर्सनल मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर, वेदर दे लाइक इट और नॉट, ऑल द टाइम. एंड आई थिंक दैट वाज नॉट देयर एज मच, यू नो, वंस द पार्टी ओपन्स अगेन, द वर्ल्ड ओपन्स एंड आई एम आउट देयर ऑल द टाइम. सो आई थिंक दैट हैज बीन गुड.
This gift of their parents and their father, especially a celebrity father being with them, and they will remember this.
कोई घर में कोई उन्हें celebrity यहाँ पे कोई feel नहीं है celebrity, but that's good. That's how we brought them up, not to have that at all. You have to study, get. I mean, अपनी report card दिखाओ celebrity, बाद में बात करेंगे.
Very good. A quick message to our students, and then we might.
Guys, like, I mean, right now, obviously, a message has to be about what's going on. देखो, गिन मत, दिन मत गिनो बैठ के, कब खत्म होगा, पागल हो जाओगे, घड़ी देखते रहोगे, कब आएंगे, 8 बजे, यू नो, वो सब नहीं करना है, वो तो होता रहेगा। सारी दुनिया लगी है खोलने में, लॉट ऑफ पीपल वॉन्ट दिस टू ओपन अप। बड़े से बड़े दिमाग लगे हुए हैं, साइंटिस्ट, डॉक्टर, लीडर्स, दे आर ऑल ट्राइंग टू फिक्स दिस एंड गेट इट ओपन। एंड सो यू सिटिंग एंड चेकिंग इट इन द न्यूज 6 times a day इज नॉट गोना हेल्प। यू से गॉड हैज गिवन मी अ गिफ्ट ऑफ दिस टाइम एंड हाउ कैन आई मेक यूज ऑफ इट। That's it. And one day it will get over, and you'll be like, "Arey, khatam ho gaya." You might actually miss the lockdown one day, huh? Believe it or not. So yeah, so don't count the days.
Don't
just count the work.
Days and just do something different and creative daily. Beautiful message from you, Chetan. First of all, thanks.
Thank you, sir.
And I also thank the lovely audience for, you know, going through this session. And I'm sure for some it will be a turning point listening to your wisdom and your answers. Yes. And we wish also to you, your family, and especially you, that you, you know, fulfill your yearning of being happy more and helping others, and especially the youngsters and the youth of the country. Thank you from Chitkara University once again. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.